Chey, see me see trouble, oh. Just when you think you have heard it all, Nigeria does not fail to deliver. Dangote say, the youths are jobless. It's just like Evans saying, I should go and find work. Shekau saying, I should go and read. Like Buhari saying, I should obey the law. It's like Good Luck Jonathan saying, stealing is not corruption. Dangote has said his own. Dangote has said, corruption is a job. He said, corruption is a profession. Nigeria never fails to deliver. The biggest looter in Africa, maybe in the whole world, is telling some people that they do not have job, that they are talking out of joblessness. The person behind the joblessness of not just Nigeria, but the joblessness of the whole Africa, because Nigeria at a stage, before Dangote came into the scene, used to support neighboring African countries. We used to pay salaries of countries when they could not, until Dangote came into the scene. 1970s. In the 70s, after his uncle gave him money, you know. First of all, when you're talking about people who have made money, you talk of people like Mark Cuban, Americans, make money from zero. Dangote first inherited money from his uncle, I think Dan Tata or something, $500,000. That na job. Then he is the number one beneficiary, parasite of Nigeria, leech. Obasanjo, first term, I'm not talking about Obasanjo's second term, Obasanjo's first term. All Obasanjo did was held on to Dangote and said, I will make you a billionaire as long as you support me financially and politically forever. Because once you're a politician, you have to find somebody on the outside to help you loot the country silly in a private individual. And that's what Obasanjo used Dangote for. Do not take it from me. Take it from Dangote's friends, his American friends. You always see him with Bill Gates, another of these people. Take it from his American friends. How did they describe him? They call Dangote, beggar thy countrymen. They say his business model. You see it from US cables in WikiLeaks. Dangote's business model is called beggar thy countrymen. Get rich by making the whole country poor. You have a friend in the government. He had Obasanjo in the government. As WikiLeaks says, you can see it here, that all the things on the ban list, import ban list from that time, and the thing still keeps repeating. Jonathan did it for him again. The things on the import ban list are the things that Dangote has interested. So whatever Dangote they want to build Dangote on, they ban it. The other thing that the Obasanjo did that time, they said Dangote said himself that Obasanjo gave him, compelled him, to import so much rice that the local market crashed. What Obasanjo used to do is he would block other people from importing, give Dangote sole importation rights. If I carry any of the Arewa youths, no, they are too brilliant for Dangote's level. They are not on his level at all. They are too good for him. If I carry a blind, crippled, mute, no, a blind cripple is too much for Dangote's level. You know, when you're talking about people who are desperate, greedy, rotten, criminal, you know, looters, you don't compare them with even people with disability. If I carry a winch, a retarded winch, and I give that winch sole importation right, that winch will become a billionaire immediately. It's the simple parasitic way of getting rich on the back of the country. This is how Obasanjo in the 70s gave Dangote sole importation right. And by Dangote's own words, he was compelled by Obasanjo to import so much rice that he crashed the local market. Dangote killed all the rice farmers in Nigeria. He killed all of them. He and Obasanjo killed the local market. His own words, was compelled to import so much rice that he killed the local market, killed farming in Nigeria. Now, after he has bought the land of the farmers, then Nembuhari are giving him to be, hey, Dangote is producing all this rice. After you kill the farmers, the same thing happened with Boko Haram. Boko Haram and Fulani herdsmen are on a mission. The mission is from the Illuminati. The mission is to destroy local farming in the farming belt
so that the Dangotes can buy up the land and take over the farming.
Now, let's go back to this Dangotes. How the... You said the Arewa youths are jobless. Oh, my God. After Obasanjo gives him sole importation rights, they give him tax exemptions, duty-free. Dangote controlled a whole port in the south that he controlled. He brings in anything he wants, any machine. He pays no duties to Nigerian government. If you give that to the retarded winch will become billionaire. He's stealing Nigeria's money because he's not paying Nigeria duties. What does he give them in return? Check out how Yar'Adua and Jonathan came into power. Obasanjo came, said, Yar'Adua, I want you to contest. Yar'Adua said, I'm sick. He said, God will heal you. This is Obasanjo, very criminal fellow. After that, Yar'Adua said, I don't have money. This is WikiLeaks. Yar'Adua said, I don't have money. He said, Dangote, open the chest, give him money. Because he's in care of Nigeria's money looted by Obasanjo in care of Dangote. So it's his money. He said, open the war chest. Dangote, they said, drop
5 billion naira or however much.
Sponsored the campaign, put Yar'Adua in. Unfortunately for him, Yar'Adua was not like the other looting cabal. May God bless Yar'Adua. May God grant him heaven, paradise. Yar'Adua fought Dangote, Elumelu, all this cabal, Obasanjo. Read it from WikiLeaks. The caption is disentangling Obasanjo. He overturned the sale of the refineries. They dashed refineries to Dangote. It's because of this cabal like Dangote that your refineries will never work. Because the oil cabal sabotaged the refineries to ensure that they were making that money, that fuel subsidy billions. Them Dangote and co. Otedola, all this cabal, the oil cabal. The first thing they do is they sabotage the refinery so that they can make their money. Again, they are sabotaging the refinery with the Ikechukwu and then Buhari once again to make sure your refineries do not work because Dangote is building his refinery. The minute your refinery does not work, his refinery stock goes up, skyrockets. Beggar thy countrymen, Dangote. He is the reason for the whole poverty in Africa. And he has the gumption. My God. I can continue on and on. They dash him. So when Yar'Adua came, let me not lose my chain of thought. When Yar'Adua came, Yar'Adua overturned the sale of the refineries to him. He accused Obasanjo's kitchen staff, according to WikiLeaks, of poisoning him. You think we don't know? They could not stand Yar'Adua. Yar'Adua fought Dangote on cement. Cement is another one. They dashed Dangote, all the cement factories in Nigeria. They give it to him. BPE, El-Rufai controlling BPE, Obasanjo time, they dash him these things at the lead, ridiculous price, no competition, no public, this thing. They dash him the cement plants anywhere. Anybody who tries to obstruct his sale of cement, he threatens to close down one plant. I'm going to lay off workers. Look at it. Yar'Adua back off cement because Yar'Adua wanted to break his monopoly. He could not stand it. He's a baby, pampered baby. Say back off cement. He threatened to, and these weak presidents would not tell him to go ahead. How many people does Dangote employ in his whole life in Nigeria? He doesn't employ more than 40,000 people. He and Atiku, his fellow Halliburton thief, the two of them keep contesting that they are the highest employers in Nigeria. They don't employ more than 40,000 people. Small businesses are the highest employers. Small businesses employ over 80 million Nigerians, not these big companies. Allow him to close down, allow him to get out. But the government will be like, oh, he's going to close down one plant. We'll threaten them. I'm going to close down one plant. Don't let Ibeto Cement. Ibeto Cement keeps complaining every day. He says, don't let Ibeto Cement import this thing. If they import it, I'm going to close down one plant. Jobs, workers will be laid off. And in the government will say, because of that, we are not going to compel him to reduce the price of cement. After dashing Dangote, tax-free, duty-free, tax exemption, every concession, free land, Fashola, they will collect land from people, kick out the elders. Fashola told elders that do not let me be angry with you. Imagine. Anyway, then they will dash him land. Guess what? He sells his cement double the international price. Nigeria cement is twice the global price of cement. Beggar thy countrymen. Twice the international price of cement is how much Dangote sells cement for. 3,000 naira a bag divided by the rate that they give him dollars. 200 something naira per dollar. He's selling cement at $10 a bag, 50 kg bag. Everywhere in the world is $5 a bag. Stealing money, making houses collapse, killing Nigerians. And he has the gumption. I'll go on again. Forex, the latest one. Then Buhari, Godwin, Emefiele. Starving the country, saying they promised Dangote unfettered continuous access of dollars. Reuters wrote the article.
Dangote was given $100 million gift based on the rates advantage. $100 million gift in just 4 months. That means the Buhari were giving him $500 million a year with the forex subsidy scam. Emir Sanusi Halad, you are making them millionaires, billionaires overnight. This is how Dangote has been looting the money and oppressing, suppressing, crippling, frustrating the masses. Baby, he cannot stand on his own. He cannot stand beside me or any of you in business. Baby. And he has the gumption to tell people that they are jobless. Hey, I don't hear him for Nigeria. Oh. Hey, this is Dr. Perry Brimah. Follow me at Every Nigerian for more lamentation and for the revolution. Because we will kick out this cabal. All of them, we will send them on self-exile in 2019 or before. We are sending them out. Join me, advancednigerian.com. They must go out of the country, out of our land. They have looted enough. King looters of Africa.